I'm here to pick up a prescription.
Hi, I'm Priya, the pharmacist, and you are?
I'm Keith.
Keith, are you the patient?
Well, no, I'm actually picking up for my son, Blake.
Okay, and what is the medication?
The doctor, Dr. Reba, said it was epinephrine?
Epinephrine? Yeah. Okay, so I see here that this is a new medication for Blake. Do you have a couple moments to go over the medication just to make sure that he's taking it safely and getting the most
sure.
benefit?
That
All right, have
good.
A seat.
Okay.
Okay. So what is your relationship to Blake?
He's my son. He's my 6-year-old.
Okay, so before we begin, I just want to verify that the information that we have on Blake
sure.
is correct. So his date of birth?
That's correct.
Okay, and is he still on?
Yes, that's true.
On Constitution Avenue. Okay, perfect. So the it says here that Blake does not have any diseases. Do you know of
He doesn't have any diseases. He actually is pretty healthy.
Okay.
Until yesterday when...
What happened yesterday?
Well, my wife and I, Carrie and I, took him to the ER because he had taken a handful of peanuts and he developed hives. And so Dr. Reba told us to come here to get medication because she thinks he has peanut allergy.
Okay, absolutely. So we can definitely go over that. Yeah. And I just want to continue with what other medications is he taking?
Nothing.
Nothing? And any over-the-counter
Nothing.
Medications? Vitamins?
Nope.
Supplements? Okay. And other than the peanut allergy, does he have any other allergies that you know of?
No, he doesn't.
All right. So just to go over this medication right now, but before I begin going into the medication, are there any other concerns that you'd like for me to address?
No, this is all really new to me, so I don't.
Okay. Well, I'll go ahead and go with the medication. So the medication that we have for Blake is epinephrine. What it is it's an injection, and it is for a severe allergic reaction. So
okay.
you mentioned that he's allergic to peanuts. You don't know when he might be exposed to peanuts, so this is really important that he keeps on him so that in case he has a peanut allergy, this can treat that, especially that difficulty breathing and the clogging of the airways. So have you ever used an EpiPen before?
No, I have not.
That's what this is. Okay. So what this is it comes in a pack of two, and I can teach you how to use it. So
sure.
this is the pen. This is the safety cap, the blue safety cap, and the orange part that covers the needle. So the way...
Is it needle? I hate needles.
You hate needles. Okay, well, the great thing about this is you're never going to see the needle
okay.
because this... and I'll explain that in a moment. So the way that you administer it is that I'll demonstrate. This is a safety cap. You're going to pull it straight up. Make sure you don't twist it or bend it.
Okay.
And then the safety cap... and you want to make sure that you're administering it only into the thigh. So nowhere else, only the thigh. That's... the greatest place to administer it.
Right.
And what you'll do is you'll hold it in your hand and then you'll sort of swing the arm and into the thigh,
okay?
Until you hear that click. Once you hear that click, the medication has been administered. Hold it for about 3 seconds and then you can take it out and the safety cap or this needle cover will cover the needle and you'll never see the needle, which is great.
Yeah,
so it's important that you practice with this trainer as well as educate Blake how to use it and maybe any other people he's around maybe at school. So an important thing is that there is liquid that's in here. Before using it, you want to make sure that it's not cloudy or it doesn't have particles in it and that the expiration date isn't expired.
Okay.
And it can be administered through clothing. And if after 15 minutes you notice that the allergic reaction isn't going away, you can go ahead and use the second pen,
All right.
but no more than the two. And then if there is a need to use it, always call 911, even if Blake does feel better after using it.
Okay.
Okay? So what has the doctor told you to expect when using this?
Well, she told me this could save his life, but if he had another outbreak that it could get worse. I mean, it just worries me just thinking about all of it, although I heard some of the things that you said that could help.
Right. Well, with this, there might be some side effects, but the things that I really want to look out for is any sort of chest pain or any further difficulty breathing. You want to let your doctor know about that. And in terms of storing this medication, store it in a cool, dry place, away from any sort of light and heat, not in a car. And then also it's really important that he does have 2 refills, so you need to come back and get those, okay?
Okay?
So just to make sure that I've conveyed this information clearly, can you repeat back to me how to administer it?
Well, it sounds like, you know, aiming it for the thigh with, you know, a certain amount of force and leaving it in there for 3 seconds. And you also said that there would be need for more, so you're going to have to come back. And
yes, exactly. So just, again, blue to the sky, orange to the thigh, okay?
Blue
and it can
sky,
be in the outer thigh. What other questions would you have for me?
No, I mean, like I said, this is all really new. I'm not really concerned about the medication at all. It's just the whole situation,
okay.
And I don't want to mess it up, and, you know, I want him to get better, too.
All right, well, if you do have any other questions, you go ahead and give me a call. My number's on the prescription.
Okay.
I'm very happy to help you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
I appreciate it.
Thank you.